to this program. Question number 1, match the list with match 2. And the list 1 is given, list 1 and list 2 are given. Here the correct answer is C. Here the electroanalytical method is amperometry. The spectroscopic method is nephelometry. The classical method is volumetry. And non-textual method is X-ray fluorescence. Therefore, answer C is the correct answer for question number 1. Question number 2. Choose the correct statement from the following. 1. The systematic errors cause a constant error, and which is correct. The accuracy can be expressed in terms of absolute and relative errors. It is also correct. The relative error is expressed in terms of ppm. It is wrong. That is, the relative error is expressed in terms of ppt, part per thousand. Then the accuracy is defined as concordance between a measured value and the accepted value. It is also correct. Therefore, for the second question, the correct answer is 1, 2, 4. The relative error is expressed in terms of ppt, part per thousand, and therefore D is the correct answer for this question. Question number 3. Choose the wrong statement from the following. A. The square of the standard deviation is called variance. Correct. The relative standard deviation RST will be equal to S by X bar. C. The coefficient of variation CV equal to X into 1000 by X. D. The standard error of mean SX, that will be equal to X by N. This is the wrong answer. Option B is the correct answer for this question. The correct statement is the standard error mean SX is equal to S divided by N power half. Number 4. The given data, the percentage of element present in a sample was found to be 20.8, 21.6, 22.1, 23.3, 21.9, and 22.8, and the summation of mn minus mt whole square, that will be equal to 3.9143, the standard deviation is. Here the correct answer is B. B equal to 0.8077, and it is explained by the equation. The standard equation is the root of summation of mn by m whole square divided by n minus 1, and this will be equal to root of 3.9143 divided by 6. N minus 1, n equal to 7, above n minus 1 will be equal to 6. Therefore, the correct answer is 0.8077. For this question, the option B is the correct answer. Question number 5. Choose the incorrect match from the following. Option A is correct. Option B is also correct. Option C, it is also correct. In option D, the F test will be equal to F of S1 square by S2 square whole power half. It is incorrect statement. Therefore, the correct answer is D. The F test will be equal to, F will be equal to S1 square by S2 square. This is the correct statement. Well, for this question, the incorrect statement is 4. That is D. F test is the incorrect match. Question number 6. Choose the correct statement from the following. Here, if the critical value Q exceeds the critical value, then the questionable value may be rejected. It is correct. The regression line Y on X is given by the equation B equal to Y bar minus A into X, where A is the slope and B is the intercept. It is also correct. C. The correlation coefficient R is a symmetrical function between x and y. It is also correct. 4. The confidence level limit is 60 to 95. It is wrong. Therefore, the correct option is D, 1, 2, 3. Our incorrect statement is 4. For that, the correct statement is the confidence level limit is 90 to 95%. Option D is correct for this question. Question number 7. For the substance X, the retention time is 16.4 minutes, and for a 30 cm column, the peak width is 1.11. The average number of plates and plate heights are. Here, the correct option is A. Average number of plate 3493, and number of the plate height is 8.588 × 10⁻³ cm. The explanation is given below. The average number of plates n will be equal to 16 × TR/W. TR is the retention time and the W is the peak width. Therefore, 16 × 16.4 ÷ 1.1² which will be equal to 3493. The number of average plate is equal to 3493. The plate height will be equal to L by N. From this problem, L will be equal to 30 and N we have already calculated, 3493. You divide 30 ÷ 3493, it gives 8.588 × 10⁻³ cm. Therefore, for this question, the correct answer is A. Question number 8. Choose the wrong statement from the following. A. The efficiency of the chromatographic system can be expressed in terms of plate numbers and plate height. It is also correct. B. The effective plate numbers, N effective will be equal to H by L, that will be equal to T dash R by sigma whole power half. The option, that is the second option, is wrong statement. Option C. The resolution of two adjacent bands in the distance between the band peaks is divided by the average band width. D. The normal DLC used when the stationary phase is polar and the mobile phase is non-polar, and in reverse phase chromatography, the stationary phase is non-polar and the mobile phase is polar, which is also correct. Therefore, the wrong statement is B. The correct answer is B. The effective plate number, that will be equal to NEF, will be equal to L by H, which will be equal to TR by sigma square. This is the correct statement. For the question number 8, option B is the wrong statement. Question number 9. Choose the correct match from the following. Here, the cations and the color and RF values are given. For all that, for the lead, the color is lead. The RF value is 0.88. It is wrong. But for Ag+, Hg2+, and Cg2+ are correct. Therefore, the correct option is 2, 3, 4. D is the correct answer. For lead, Bb2+, the correct color is red, but RF value is 0.08. For the question number 9, the option B is the correct answer. Question 10. Choose the following cation which have the value of RF equal to 1 N butanol. You know very well, generally the RF value of the anions or cations may be less than 1. For certain ion, the value of RF equal to 1. For this question, the option A is correct. Fe3+, CO2+, Cu2+, and Cd2+ are having the RF value equal to 1. The correct answer is A for this question. Question number 11. Choose the correct order of increasing of RF values for the anions in butanol. Here, The correct option is C. SO4 2 minus ion less than Cl minus ion less than Br minus ion less than I minus ion. For SO4, the RF value is 0.07. For Cl minus ion, 0.24. For Br minus ion, 0.36. For I minus ion, 0.47. Therefore, SO4 2 minus ion has the lowest RF value and I minus ion has the highest RS value. Therefore, the correct increasing order of RF values of the anion in N-butanol is C. The correct answer is C. Question number 12. In paper chromatography, the separation of silver, lead, mercury and the solvent front was 18 cm while the front duty element are 16, 12 and 6 cm respectively. The RF value of the all material. Here the correct option is A. 0.88, 0.66, 0.3. The correct answer is A. And how you are going to calculate RF value? For RF value formula, the distance moved by the solute divided by the distance moved by the solvent. For the first case, the distance moved by the solute is 16 and the distance moved by the solvent is 18. Therefore, 16 by 18 will be equal to 0.88. For second case, 12 divided by 18, 0.66. For third one, 06 divided by 18, this will be equal to 0.33. This is the RF value for all the metal. Therefore, option A is correct for this question. Question number 13. The substance having nearly the same RF value can be distinguished by. Here, the best option is B. 2D paper chromatography is the correct answer. Answer B is the correct answer for this question. 14. Choose the strong adsorbent in adsorption chromatography. Here option A and option B are the mild adsorbent. The option C, alumina, bauxite and charcoal are the strong adsorption. Therefore, the option C is the correct answer for the question 14. Question number 15. Choose the correct order of decreasing eluting power of the solvent. Here, the correct answer is B. Formamide, water, methanol, ethanol and N-propanol, and it is in the decreasing order. Option B is the correct. Question number 16. The electrode used in electrochemical detector in HPLCL. The correct answer is A. Classy carbon working electrode plus silver chloride reference electrode. Option A is correct. Question number 17. When a gas comes in contact with a liquid, the amount of gas gets dissolved in the liquid follows. Here, the correct answer is Henry's law. According to Henry's law, the amount of gas get dissolved is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the gas dissolved. Therefore, the option C is correct. Question number 18. Choose the correct order of increasing exchange capacity by the following cation. Here, the option A is correct. Na plus less than Ca2 plus less than Al3 plus less than Th4 plus. Here, the exchange capacity increases with the increasing charges of the cation. Therefore, the correct answer is option A. Question number 19. Choose the correct statement from the following. 1. The sodium vapor lamp having 589 nanometer absorption line is used as a source in atomic absorption spectra. This is correct. Question number two, the disadvantages of AAS requiring the same source for the different element being analyzed. It is wrong statement. Three, the wavelength of AES decreases with increasing atomic number of atom. It is also correct. Four, the emission spectra of magnesium atom gives a singlet and a triplet series of light. It is also correct. Therefore, the correct answer is D, 1, 3, 4. Here, the emission absorption of fluorescent spectra atomic particles consists of well-defined narrow lines due to electronic transition of inner electron. It is also wrong. Of statement 2 and statement 5 are wrong. The explanation given in the next slide. In the statement 2, the disadvantages of AAS requiring different source for different elements being analyzed. This is correct. For 5, the emission, absorption or fluorescence spectra atomic particle consists of well-defined narrow lines due to the electronic transition of the outer electron. This is the correct statement. Therefore, for this question, option D is the correct answer. 20. The modified form of Ilkoi equation ID is the product of solution factor, electrode factor and correction factor. The electrode factor is S. Here, the correct answer is B, m power 2 by 3, t power 1 by 6. This is the electrode factor. And the option A is the solution factor and option C is the correction factor. Therefore, the correction due to electrode factor is B, m power 2 by 3, t power 1 by 6. The correct answer is option B. 21. Choose the correct statement from the following recording polarography. 1. It is possible to carry out the reduction as well as oxidation at dropping mercury electrode. 2. A plot of current as a function of potential applied to the polarographic cell is known as polarograph. It is also correct. 3. The migration effect is eliminated by adding an inert electrolyte called supporting electrolyte or indifferent electrolyte, example KCl or K103. The limiting current of lead ion decreases with the addition of supporting electrolyte KNO3 and become constant at a higher concentration of K103. It is in polarographic analysis, the oxygen is not removed by bubbling inert gas and freon 12. This is wrong. In dropping mercury electrode can be applied over the range of +2.4 to -3.1 volt with reference of standard Calomel electrode. Option C is also correct. Therefore, this question, option D is the correct answer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. All the 5 statements are correct. The 5th statement is wrong. The correct statement for 5th one is, in polarographic analysis, the oxygen is removed by bubbling inert gas and freon 12. This is the correct statement. Therefore, for this question, the correct option is D. 22. Choose the wrong statement from the following regarding cyclic voltammetry. A. The process is conducted using electrodes with a small surface area in an unstirred solution producing a very small redox current. Correct. B. The two curves in cyclic voltammetry are due to cathodic reduction and anodic reduction wave as voltage reverse. It is also correct. C. The curves are linearly vertical aligned indicate that the electrode process is a slow irreversible reaction. It is wrong. D. The peak to peak separation delta E is directly related to the number of electrons transferred in the reaction. Therefore, the wrong statement is C. Therefore, the correct answer for the question is C. here in this for the scene, the wrong statement. The correct statement is the curves are linearly vertical aligned, indicating the electrode process is a slow reversible reaction. This is the correct statement for the statement C. 23. Choose the incorrect match from the following regarding DTA and DGA analysis. A. The sharp endothermic peak, the changes in crystallinity and fusion process. Correct. B. Broad endothermic peak, dehydration reaction. It is also correct. C. Exothermic peak, chemical reaction or oxidative reaction. It is also correct. D. Curic temperature, a decrease in weight of the ferromagnetic sample. It is wrong. Therefore, the option D is correct answer. It is incorrect match. The correct statement is, the correct match is, at Curie temperature, we find an increase in the weight of the ferromagnetic sample. For the question number 23, the correct answer is D. Question number 24. Using 4358 AMSA unit lines of mercury as the source of radiation on a Raman line was observed at 4447 AMSA unit. The Raman shift is. For this, the correct answer is B, 460 cm. The solution is given below. For Raman shift, the formula is 10 to the power of 8 divided by lambda excitation in AMSA unit and minus 10 to the power of 8 divided by lambda Raman AMSA unit. You substitute the value of lambda excitation as well as lambda Raman in the equation, you will get the answer. Lambda excitation is 4.358 into 10 to the power of 3 and 4.47 into 10 to the power of 3. The correct value is 460 cm minus 1. You have to given in terms of AMSA unit. You substitute the value, you will get the value 460 cm power minus 1. Here, the lambda values are given in terms of Armstrong unit. That is, 4358, we are written as 4.358 into 10 to the power of 3. 4447 Armstrong unit, it is written as 4.447 into 10 to the power of 3. Okay, the values lambda excitation as well as the lambda Raman is given in terms of Armstrong unit. Directly you give in Armstrong unit, you will get the result. The correct value is 460 cm per minus 1. For this question, option B is the correct answer. It is a very simple question. A molecule AB2C2 in which A, B, C are different atoms exhibit different IR and Raman bands. The geometry of the molecule. If a system exhibit different IR and Raman band, therefore the structure will be transplanar. Therefore, the option C is the correct answer. For 25th question, the correct answer is C.